I'm in total, call it dominatrix or boss bitch mode or independent woman, impulsive, creative. This guy just got over to go the exact same speed as the guy next to him. I find that excessively irritating. God. Sometimes it feels like people purposely get in front of me because, like, just to slow me down. Like, they get in front of me and then they go super slow. That or she was eating a banana and just didn't care. She was totally eating a banana. So, I'm thinking of all the ways you can please your goddess this morning. And in many ways, goddess has already done things to please herself. Some things being things she has done in her car. And some things being that she has fucking booked her airplane to the gathering, and yes, I will be obligated to drive to Orlando, and I'll be leaving my house around 6 o'clock in the morning. I actually might even leave earlier because cheaper parking, basically. I gotta look into that. There's like cheap parking facilities near the airport, and then they drive you to the airport, or I can just pay the fee of convenience and park at the airport, and I think it's like $19 a day. So the ways that you can please your goddess is to reimburse me for my getaway. I think it was like $230 total. And that's just flight. PayPal, Cash App. I really like all the new submissives that have been stepping through. I hope to see those pan out into some more permanent servitude. And then there's, of course, the other ones who say that they're going to send and still have yet to send, and usually just spend a majority of their time talking about what they're going to do and what they would like to do and play with their fantasy, and then once the fantasy is done, they never send. I'm looking for true, real submissives, people that really want to play and spend time with me and heal and explore themselves, etc. Ah. Orlando, huh? I could technically leave the night before. I'm pretty sure He Pays is in Orlando and not Miami anymore. Just have to figure some of this out. Whew. There's also an Airbnb I've been wanting to get near Orlando. It's actually a yurt. Super romantic and beautiful. Certainly a must experience. I'm kind of looking forward to seeing my teacher. My teacher has like really cool energy. She reminds me a lot of myself, except it seems like she has more anxiety. And I actually have been doing some studies this morning, which I'm sure many of you already know this. However, I've officially come to the conclusion that sugar causes anxiety and depression. So if you're like me and consume large amounts of sugar, then yes, that will explain your depression and your anxiety. And also, it's not necessarily always your fault because you don't even know it, and your beverages have like 27 grams of sugar in just simply 8 fluid ounces. I strongly suggest you to measure out how many grams that is actually in a Ziploc bag to actually give yourself a conscious understanding exactly how much sugar you truly are consuming. While in the grams it seems like nothing, you really need to recognize how much that really is. Somehow I managed to make it to school on time. I have 10 minutes. 10 minutes still. And I got gas. I still gotta buy some locusts.
I recently had to change all my signs at the museum and remove the word psychic from it. Apparently, you need a permit to be a psychic or something like that. Or to use that name. I don't really understand. Frankly, I would like to, and I definitely might just have to go to City Hall and talk to her. Just out of curiosity, you know? However, at the same time, like, I almost don't even want to deal with it, because in the code,
it says no fortune telling and no, like, palm reading, no psychic stuff, because they don't want St. Augustine to be another Casadega, and Casadega even then is, like, small, you know, although their energy big. I would love to go there again.
I haven't been there on my own in a long time, not since I first left the museum.
I need to give my car lots of love too. I've been procrastinating that.
Confucius, if you're working, if you're watching, all of the above,
listening,
I need to hang out with you, and you need to show me how to change my brakes and do all that stuff. I know I've been procrastinating, and now I'm going to Orlando, and I probably should have did it before now, and it's too late.
I just watched my teacher and
a student go into the building. I should probably go in. I have so much stuff I need to do. I'm kind of hoping the museum closes today, because then, you know, I'll feel more okay with just being home all day. Definitely think I should actually go home after this and clean my car, at least so I can feel like some kind of accomplishment when I come back to class, instead of hanging out on campus. I hate driving back and forth, though. That kind of sucks. I still have to deal with my mile IQ and log all my drives. Boo! What sucks is it also logs the drives when I drive with other people. Like, my phone, like, doesn't know. So I gotta figure out which drives are not the drives I've made and stuff like that, too. So super boo on that. And then definitely would like to skate today. I got my skate shoes. Totally not wearing the thing that girls are supposed to wear, or that they're told that they're supposed to wear. Oh, can we talk a little bit about my outfit? Okay, number one, I'm wearing D1PW, which is the first, like, wrestling federation I ever actually wrestled for. And now I'm also wearing, like, I call these my wrestling pants. Like, I've been training in these pants since I first started wrestling, which was, like, I was 15. And look, every pocket has a hole. I would love to find a seamstress in my city that I like, and then, like, bring her all these clothes that I have that desperately need to be repaired. These being one of them. The number one thing I do, though, is I always, I rip a hole in my crotch, believe it or not. So I don't know how I do it. I split the seam every time. I've thrown away so many pants. I actually just threw away pants, like, 2 weeks ago. Yeah, I'm just sitting in my car charging up. I'm starting to get really, really, really excited. I'm super thankful. I know this is so irresponsible. I know, and it's dangerous. I'm going off by myself, and, like, I'm impulsive. I just got to. I may have to catch an Uber from Columbus, Ohio Airport to the gathering, which may cost a total of $60. It's 45 minutes away. So, I know. Hey, by the way, DJ Kitty Scratch, anybody that works for Uber or does driving services and stuff like that, I know that there's, or anybody that just, like, does this or may know this. All right, so when I was in Bellingham, Washington, I had to catch an Uber. And this dope-ass Uber driver, he told me about this website where I can, like, it's, like, where all Uber drivers network together and they all do Lyft. It's like a driving site or whatever. And then, like, I can contact them in their area and let them know, like, hey, I'm going to be in your area. Can you pick me up at the airport this time, be my driver for this time or this time? So it's, like, you can, like, you know, read about them, and they have profiles. I don't remember what it's called. I'd love to find that again. I got a lot of root chakra stuff going on, or you could say orange chakra. gotta handle that jing, that high energy. I gotta release that, get rid of that. It's a distraction. It's getting in the way. Sometimes it's actually also like fuel, empowering fuel. So it's good to like build it up as well. I'm gonna have to go through my closet when I get home and figure out like what am I wearing. I think I'll only be working two nights, so I think I only need two dresses that are for the events. And yeah, I need to get those together. Yep. That's a must. I need heels I can easily walk in. I wanted to do the Lubies and work that gimmick. Although, it's not very easy to go down that ramp, man. I had to not wear heels at Hallowicked because the ramp was just so intense. So, we'll see. Heels are a must, though. So, I mean, if I have to bring 4 or 5 pairs of shoes, that's another thing. Like, I might have to check a bag, so that could be extra cash. Let's just say all next week, tributes from now until I come back home on the 22nd. Please. I also must push the agenda of the giant dog tooth calcite on my wish list. Or both. Or all of the above, right? Alright, your spoiled brat is about to sign off. You wanna see me this morning?
Oi.
Being weird at school. I'm hungry.
I haven't ate anything. I've been going since I got up though. And I'm glad I got my flight booked. I got my gas. I got my stuff. I got like 4 minutes till class.
I'm super nervous. I'm super excited. Like, I'm all charged up. I'm
rowdy. I definitely want to skate. Definitely have to skate today. Skating is a must. Cleaning up the room is a must.
I gotta clean the bathroom. It's my week to clean the bathroom. And they're letting me do it on Monday, so no fights. Whatever, man.
I'll do it. I don't want to do it, but I'll do it. I'm shy. I'm gonna have to tell my teacher that I'm really doing it too. That I'm like going to the gathering.
And I'm still waiting on KG to wake up.
I'm like a worrywart.
Like, KG's gonna wake up and be like, oh, by the way, I changed my mind. Waste of money. I don't know. I don't know. I'm still learning like people and stuff, so. I'm gonna try to update you today and try to catch you up. I know I gave you a lot. I encourage you to catch up if you can, man. If you can go back and watch all those videos, man.
I got a lot of heart, a lot of passion. But at the same time, it's my journey. Like, so don't worry if you don't. Just stay smiling. Take care of yourselves. Be positive.
More Barefoot Travel soon.